14-1 with a lead at halftime. And as we start the second half, West Virginia with the ball. As Deshaun Butler tries to cut in, down to Alexander, had a very good first half, draws the foul that time as McDermott gets him. Let's check in with Shauna Haswood, a chance to check up with Tim Welsh.
Hi guys, I'm here with Coach Welsh. Coach, got really sticky there in the last 5 to 6 minutes.
We stopped scoring. We had 36 points, I think it was 36-23 with 6 minutes to go, and we stopped scoring. We took some bad shots, our guards, one pass and a shot. Can't do that. You got to work the ball, and that stopped our transition game because it got their transition game going. They scored 8 out of the last 9 possessions, so got into a half-court game for us, and we took quick shots. We got to run better offense, and then that'll help our defense. That'll help our transition. That'll help everything. So we talked about that at halftime.
Good luck, Coach. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Shauna. It did appear that he was very unhappy with some of the shot selections a couple times down the floor as well. Pretty quick, as he said.
There were some quick threes of that alley-oop that didn't connect. I think things came too easily, and then all of a sudden, Providence was in a rush. Nice pass right there.
Randall Hanke, who got 5 points early in the first half and then sat the rest of the first half, starts the second half, has got a basket there with authority, and now 7 points in the game.
Well, as I said early, Hanke is a finisher, so as long as he does a solid job boxing out, he's on the floor. He's a guy that can get it done offensively for sure, so see if his minutes increase in the second half. And also see for Providence if Jeff McDermott becomes more offensive-minded for the Friars.
All that time for Xavier. He picks up his first personal of the game. From the corner, Ruoff. Off the back and the rebound. Roman going up to get it, and he was fouled on the play. That time, Hanke on the foul. Let's revisit our star watch from the beginning. Joe Alexander has had a big game, 13 points so far. And Dwayne Williams with 6 points so far. A couple of three-pointers for Dwayne Williams.
Well, Alexander was huge for West Virginia, and I'm just impressed with his lateral movement, ability to get the shot off. Doesn't go there. We'll see if Providence can get that kind of start going like they had at the beginning of the game.
Yeah, McKenzie going up with it, and it's hit in the neck area, it appeared, and the foul.
Charged to West Virginia,
22 that time on the foul, Alex Ruoff.
Third personal foul. Team has one. Joe Mazzulla.
Third foul for Ruoff.
For West Virginia.
It's like they caught him before he went up into the act of shooting, so just an inbound play as Ruoff gets a seat.
Well, three personals will sit now, and Friars here trying to set it up. A two-point West Virginia lead.
Man-to-man.
McDermott kicks it back out again. Williams with another long-range shot. He's got 9 three-pointers in the game for Dwayne Williams.
It was a nice passing effort by McDermott. Again, unselfish. He didn't force it. Kicked it out and set up the three ball.
Quickly answered by Mazzulla. Had a nice first half in his return to Rhode Island.
Boy, that's just nice execution. West Virginia runs a very disciplined offense with good cutting, back doors. You've got to be very alert away from the ball, not to stare at the ball or you'll get burned. You've got to stay between your man and the basket at all times.
McDermott for three. The Friars starting to get that three-point bid going. Can't get that to go. And on the rebound quickly up is Darris Nichols. Alexander, who was hot in the first half, has missed three in the second half. Roman going back up again. Hanke met him. And the loose ball comes away with Xavier.
McDermott always seems to come up with the loose ball. He is tough as nails in traffic.
It's been a quiet game for Xavier, who puts it up with a three-point bid, but the rebound for Alexander.
Again, there's all kinds of time on the shot clock. That's what Tim Welsh is talking about right there. Work it, make an extra pass, and see if you can come up with a better look.
Sean Butler looking to Throwman. Now Nichols for three. Nichols got 9 points in the game now. Senior from Radford, Virginia.
It's an example of it. Thurlman had what looked like an open shot at the top, didn't take it, made the extra pass, and they got it to the right man in Nichols.
He's setting up down low, kicks it back out. McDermott spinning his way in, is foul. McDermott, who passes so often, a great assist man. And at times, I think Tim Welsh would like to have him score some more. And that's one thing McDermott can do. He does a little bit of everything. But assists for such a big man, we've seen it over the course of his career at Providence College. He's truly been amazing in that regard. He averages over 10 a game, 10.9, 8.5 rebounds per game.
I think he should look for his shot more. And I didn't think he got as many touches in the first half. Get the ball in his hands. He should look for his shot more. And when he doesn't have, he's a great passer. So get him more involved in the offense. And he's got to present himself more for the basketball as well.
Roman coming out of the game as John Flowers checking back in now for Bob Huggins.
Here's one of the things, Don, when you take a lot of quick shots, you're not getting the ball in his hands enough. If three balls are going up a lot, let him touch it, let him drive, get to the foul line, and then he can dish and kick out to guys for really open looks.
The 63% foul shooter got the first one to go. Can't get the second one to go.
Wanted it, just wouldn't drop in off the rim there.
West Virginia by three with the ball. Missoula has tied his career high with 11 points, and he's done it two previous times. He's a sophomore out of Johnston, Rhode Island. Like West Virginia Mountaineers.
Looks like Providence is in a 2-3 matchup zone right now. Should give a couple of open looks.
Wellington Smith too strong, and the rebound for Xavier. Quickly up the floor, and Williams, another quick shot, and he can't get it to go, and the rebound. Again, the Friars putting it up quickly.
And Hankey's down low. Work it, see if you can get the ball inside to him a couple of times. You cannot rely exclusively on that jump shot.
Alexander's been quiet now in the second half after a fantastic first half. Look down low, and it's Smith on the turnaround. No good, and the rebound quickly taken by McDermott. Kenzie bringing it up. McDermott now penetrating, and the foul. Well, the stoppage here is timeout on the floor. Super Bowl coming up. We'll have some fun facts for you. West Virginia by three. 47-44 West Virginia on top. And of course, in these parts, it's been a long 2 weeks waiting for the Super Bowl to roll around. And here we go, as it'll happen tomorrow. World Series and Super Bowl champions, same metro area, same season. Of course, the Red Sox world champions in 04. Patriots able to do it. Can they do it again as a tandem? Some of the others over the years, of course, the Bay Area, the metro area, Oakland and San Francisco. And the pursuit of perfection, of course, Miami 17-0. Patriots with a win tomorrow would go 19-0. And of course, these two teams playing tomorrow have already matched up once and was a pretty good game. And for the Giants, they showed up, even though it didn't mean a lot to them that first time around. They showed up in a big way, and it was a pretty good contest.
That was a great game, 38-35. The Patriots prevailing. I just feel like they're on a mission, Don, and they've found a way all year long. In the latter stages, they found ways to win games. I think they get it done tomorrow.
Haven't had a lot of experience in losing this year.
They really haven't. They get it done. And you just have to like having Tom Brady come the fourth quarter if we're in a tight one.
I like their chances. As Dwayne Williams all the way back to grab it for the Friars. They trail by three. They trailed by three at halftime. Seemed to get a little momentum started in the second half, but West Virginia answering quickly. As Jeff Xavier's been quiet in this one, off to Williams. Xavier looking for his 1,000th career point.
Got to get the ball inside a bit. They've got Hankey in there. They're just not getting him some touches.
Xavier can't get the three to go. The rebound, though, for McKenzie on top. Now Hankey down low, and there you go. And there's the touch.
And it comes from Jeff McDermott. The guards really have to look for Hankey a bit more there. All looking for threes right now. You've got the three guard lineup. I think Hankey and McDermott inside are the answers for the Friars right now. 2-3 zone by Providence.
I mentioned the Friars coming in with 438 three-pointers. You think there are too many three-pointers going up right now for the Friars?
I do. I think the quick shot, I think if it presents itself, Don, after several passes and it's open, go for it. I think they need to look for more penetration.
Sean Butler thought about going in, but he was met by McDermott. Pulls it out, a three-point bid way off the mark. And time had expired on the shot clock. So the Friars getting it back here. Bob Huggins wanted a three-second violation. Randall Hanke was able to get the last bucket for the Friars. 3 for 3 from the field. He continues to be outstanding. 3 for 3 from the line. 9 points. A perfect night for a guy who's usually perfect from the field.
Now he's got that 68% field goal mark coming in.
68 this season, 69 in his collegiate career at Providence College, the all-time leader in field goal percentage. And Thurlman coming back in. As Flowers will sit down for West Virginia. And down and Missoula knocked it out. Friars will get it back. Nice game so far, and Joe Mazzulla's return here to Rhode Island. Inbounded for McDermott.
Good man-to-man defense right now.
This one off of McDermott as he tried to make a move towards the baseline. Kicked it out of bounds. West Virginia will get it back.
Don't see that too often by the big fella. He's usually very good with the basketball, but good defense, again, out of that man-to-man set. That's been the difference since probably midway through the first half. West Virginia's really picked up the D.
Steal in tight. Xavier on a nice play defensively. Back now comes Williams.
An unusual turnover by Nichols.
Hanke. Missoula on the rebound for West Virginia. They lost last time out 69-39 to Cincinnati, but shooting much better tonight than they did last time out. A dreadful outing for them.
I think that was just a flat off game for the Mountaineers. Really unusual with the season they've had. Good look inside.
Ruman back out again now. And hitting is Darius Nichols.
Some really nice inside-out passing by West Virginia here tonight. They get it inside, and they kick that ball out very well.
That's three-pointer, 12 points now for Darius Nichols. Quickly inside to Hanke. Goes around and gets the roll. Switched hands.
Then he went back to his left. You get him the ball inside, and more often than not, he finds a way to get it done. As the Friars close to within two, we've got ourselves a good one here tonight.
Matthew with 11 points now. Back to the corner, Nichols for three. Off the front end, the rebound down low, blocked away.
Randall Hanke getting involved at both ends of the floor. I'd be really surprised after that block if Hanke sits the way he did in the first half, which was for a long, long stretch. Ray Hall into the game. Give Hanke a rest. He's been playing some good ball for the Friars.
Well, the first time he scored 5 points, then did not see action again in the first half. And Hall in to give him a bit of a break. Alexander having a tough time in the second half. This goes out of bounds, and it's going the other way. Friars get it back. Alexander having a tough time in the second half, was really feeling it in the first half. Junior from Mount Airy, Maryland.
Now one of the things you see with this West Virginia team is they are not big inside. Alexander at 6'8". We've got some players that are 6'7", 6'8", but they don't have the, you know, the Ray Hall, Randall Hanke height up front. Nice trap. You make up for that with aggressive perimeter defense. In a good team concept on defense to cut down angles, and you've got to box out. Tim Welsh working it over there with John Cal. The coaches get a good workout in during the games. John Cal seems unfazed.
I know you think John Cal is one of the best officials in all the game.
I really do. He's, I'm not sure how many, but he's been in, you know, a number of championship games. He's worked the Final Four a number of times. Just a rock solid official.
Ruoff on the foul. That's four personals now for Ruoff. Ruoff will have to sit down. Missoula checking back in now for West Virginia. West Virginia has won 5 of the last 6 meetings against Providence College. They'll meet again in 3 weeks from tonight. That'll be at the West Virginia University Coliseum. Another round between these two teams. The 99th season in West Virginia for their basketball. It has been a historic team over the years. And some great teams over the last few years. Trying to make another run in the Big East this year. Of course, NIT champions last year. This one loose on the floor. The battle and The timeout on the floor for West Virginia as they recovered. They've got a two-point lead with 11:52 left here in the second half. West Virginia on top by two. Golf fans and club pros, it's not too early to start thinking about the 2008 ESPN National Golf Challenge. Log on to ESPNGolf.com to sign up your course as a host or find a local qualifying site in your area. Be part of the search for America's best twosome. Well, a good one tonight from the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island. Randall Hanke continues to sit. Friars turn that one into a full timeout as it turned out. Let's take a look now at our select stats brought to you by Select Sector Spiders. And 5 for 10 of three-pointers, West Virginia. A lot of three-pointers for Providence. They're 6 for 16.
Yeah, it's probably too many threes by Providence. They need to go inside a bit more. West Virginia shooting just 3 for 13 in the second half as Providence shows some pressure really for the first time tonight. Three-quarter court, 2-2-1, just to make West Virginia work to bring the ball up the court. Good idea by Tim Welsh out of the timeout, mixing it up. I think mixing it up and causing teams to have to recognize the defense is always a good idea during the course of a game so they don't settle in and get comfortable.
Roman trying to get around Big Ray Hall, so he stops and pops. It was zero left on the clock that time. Just didn't get it off. And the first 2 points of the game now for the Roman.
Great job on that one by Cam. He just kind of did the step back, made it look easy.
Turn around for Hall, got it up but couldn't get it to go, and it's out of bounds. It'll stay the Friars' ball. Timeout on the floors. It's a 52-48 lead for West Virginia. .52-48 West Virginia on top, and they've used a three to get good size lead and keep it here in this one coming back in the second half.
Well, both teams like the three, but West Virginia's been more selective and made higher percentage of the shots. They're at about 50%. Ruoff Nichols made the first one, made another one there, and it's really been from inside out passing. There's Nichols again. He's been dynamite, but the beneficiary of some nice kick out passes, which West Virginia does so well. Oh, nice play by Nichols again.
Well, Missoula getting contact. Roll's not there, but on the other side, it is Deshaun Butler able to get it in for West Virginia. On top now by six, led by three at halftime. Deshaun Butler on the rebound. We're here at the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island. The West Virginia Mountaineers and the Providence College Friars. Don Orsillo along with Bron Perry and Shauna Hassett. Friars in their home gray. The Mountaineers in blue. Well, the Friars had an early lead in this one, but it has been West Virginia since then. And a pass to nowhere that time for Thuruman. As he missed the mark, Bob Huggins none too pleased.
There's not a doubt about it when Bob Huggins not happy with the play, but they're looking for execution. West Virginia doing a good job, and just to make a pass like that seemed kind of careless. No doubt about it.
Norman, the freshman that time, making the pass.
I think one of the issues for Providence is no one really taking charge of the offense. Sherrod Curry, he's been out now with that foot problem, doesn't seem to be getting better. And this offense right now out of sync against West Virginia's D.
Sherrod Curry's been a tough guy to figure out this year as far as playing, coming back. It's been a very tough injury for him, the foot. And of course, playing one game, trying to come back the 19th of December. Played about, 7 minutes, and then the next day the boot went back on again and has not played since.
Very slow to heal foot injury. Missing more and more time for the Friars. And the difference here is you see him.
He led the team in scoring last year, the junior from Gainesville, Georgia.
Very difficult to sit and watch, but the thing is he's the floor general, and Dwayne Williams with that capability, but looking more for the three-point shot right now. But somebody's got to step up. Xavier, McKenzie, and the guy they look to a lot is Jeff McDermott, not on the floor right now. So this offense struggling, and I think Darris Nichols on the other side of the ball doing a nice job running things. for West Virginia.
Largest lead of the night for the Mountaineers, on top now by eight. Inside 10 minutes to play. As this one knocked away by Deshaun Butler, the Friars will keep it.
See, it's a three guard lineup right now, but McKenzie and Efajuku really are the off guards. Xavier, a shooter as well, but I think of the three, best chance that he can take the ball, run the club a bit.
This is a team, the Friars, who do spread it around quite a bit. Five different Friars averaging over 10 points per game. And they are a team that does that, but they are missing the guy at the top. And that has been a key all season long, it appears. And we've seen McDermott at times take over at the point when he's in. Certainly a good assist man. As Hankey kicks it back out off Xavier's. Had a quiet contest tonight for the Friars. Now Xavier, 2 seconds on the clock, and just getting it off. Underneath that time was Efajuku. Well, he's got nine.
That wasn't pretty, but they were able to get it done when they had to. Sometimes you just let instincts take over when that shot clock's about to run down.
Efajuku with 9 points, his return to the Friars lineup tonight.
The other nice thing when you're on the road, Don, if you play from in front, you take the crowd out a bit, and this has been quiet in here at the Dunkin' Donuts Center.
Zulu with the try that time on the foul underneath. Deshaun Butler may have gotten a piece. The clock was really winding down here when the Friars got this basket.
Xavier, though, did a good job. That's the penetration I'm talking about. And he really just did it because the shot clock was running down. Xavier can do those things and perhaps should handle the ball a bit more right now for the Friars. McKenzie up top with it.
Deshaun Butler was on the foul, his third personal. It's the sixth team foul.
It's Dwayne Williams back in the game. Good move by Tim Welsh to get him out there and say, hey, be the floor general. Take charge of the troops and get some penetration and get the ball to the open man.
Kenzie with a good move. Stops, pops, and misses everything that time, but Hankey comes down with it. He was fouled. There's Randall Hankey back on the floor for the Friars. Got a quick rest. Ray Hall was in for a bit, but Hankey that time fouled. And that time the foul on Joe Alexander.
Now this is a rarity, but this is just a complete air ball. The ball not really controlled by McKenzie, and good work by Hankey. He was definitely hammered in there by Joe Alexander underneath.
Alexander's first personal has Hankey at the line. Hankey is a 76% foul shooter. Good at go this time.
That was a bonus foul. That was the 17th foul by West Virginia. Providence 2-3 zone. They've got to get their hands up on the defensive end. The hands are all down. Gives the offense excellent passing lanes to move the ball.
Perlman off the back end. Trying to re-gab the rebound and a foul on the bid. It's a 6-point West Virginia lead with 7:54 left to go from the Dunkin' Donuts Center. Okay. 56-50, West Virginia on top, 7:54 to go. And of course, this is the weekend, the American Cancer Society and Coaches versus Cancer. A lot of the coaches wear their suits along with sneakers. They have the last few years, so this weekend, the first through the third. And participating coaches and their coaching staffs wearing sneakers instead of dress shoes, their usual game attire during the weekend. Show support for the American Cancer Society in the fight against cancer. Bob Huggins, of course, wearing his. Not going with the suit, though, as he goes with the pullover. It's a nice look, though.
It is. Yeah. Game ready. I'm surprised more coaches don't wear pullovers. You can see the sneakers. Really, it's really a show of support by the coaches across the country for what's obviously a fantastic cause. And you see it, you know, all day long. You've been seeing it, Don. So it's a great thing. And certainly, hopefully, the dollars and funds will continue to be raised in support of the research for cancer.
On the right side, long range from Darius Nichols, a three-pointer.
Boy, Nichols has been great knocking those threes down. Got 15 in the game now, and he's been very effective from three-point land.
Brooks looking for help as Xavier drops down to Hankey. Boy, they've gone down there to Hankey. He has been able to deliver, and he does here. 13 points now for Randall Hankey.
He also catches the ball well in traffic, and that was a good example of it. Well, Providence, they're down 7. Their thing is really the reverse of what West Virginia did in the first half. They need to really increase their intensity on defense to get some stops. Oh, nice look.
Alexander been quiet in the second half, comes up big that time.
Oh, man, did he come up big. That got the whole West Virginia bench up. And if you need a wake-up call on defense, this is the one right here. That is authoritative. And if you're Providence, you're saying, hey, this is a home game. And Joe Alexander just doing that one, flushing it. And it is all West Virginia right now. Providence is going to pick it up on defense.
Alexander with 15 points. Can't convert on the three-point play. Williams will bring it back. Williams looking for friends, almost threw it away, and does as Xavier ends up stepping on the line. Go the other way.
See, Jeff Xavier tried to call that timeout, but he was in the air calling it, which a couple years ago was allowed. Not now. Good call by John Cal saying no go.
Hall checks back in. Hanke will sit down. McKenzie also sitting down now for the Friars. So again.
Yep, that's a great look at it. He's on his way. He's in the air, about to land out of bounds, and not allowed as a timeout now. The Friars have got to bear down on defense. They're in the zone. We'll see if Tim Welsh might go a little man-to-man. West Virginia very disciplined against both the zone and the man. That's a travel. Up and down. It's the old schoolyard play. Up and down. He went up. Defense recovered that time.
Yeah, no place to go for Nichols once he got up into the air.
Nice recovery by Charlie Birch. He's really the one that forced that. McDermott back in the game, and the Friars, with 6+ to go, need to make their run now. They've got good offense, and they've got to play even better defense at the other end.
Birch fouled as he was cutting in. Not sure that time Wellington Smith had his arms in the air. And it is Smith. It's his fourth personal.
Providence, a team that can score points in bunches. They can do it at home. They can make threes. West Virginia very disciplined with the ball. Boy, Nichols plays such an important role for this Mountaineer team, running the offense. He's a senior, he's a veteran on a very young team.
83% foul shooter is Birch. And on the front end of the one and one, can't get it to go.
A couple of front ends they've missed now with Birch and Hanke. That's the equivalent of 4 points that you miss out on.
Thurlman thought about challenging Hall, sends it back out to the corner for three.
Wow.
Harris Nichols again. Largest lead of the contest for West Virginia, on top by 12. Tim Welsh wants to talk it over. 30-second timeout. Harris Nichols has been outstanding. Let's take a look now at a game-changing performance brought to you by Pontiac, and it is Harris Nichols.
Now, Harris Nichols has been great. Knocking the threes down, hitting on backdoor cuts. He's the floor general for West Virginia. Game-changing performance goes to Nichols, primarily with the three ball and also with his just overall floor general play for West Virginia. Check it out. There's three of his threes. The southpaw can really feel it. He's made four threes in the game. He's got 18. He has been the man.
West Virginia here on the road after back-to-back home losses. Here trying to beat Providence College. They have wins in the Big East this year against Marquette, Syracuse, St. John's, and South Florida. And trying to beat the Friars here tonight on their home court in front of a large crowd here at the Dunkin' Donuts Center.
Now, they took charge of this game probably three quarters of the way through the first half with their defensive intensity. They're very good with the basketball. And right now, Providence has got to make their run, and they've got to do it with some good looks and good defense.
West Virginia out shooting Providence 17-6 in the last 7.5 minutes, outscoring, I should say.
That's a break for Providence. Good defense by West Virginia, but the ball went out off of them, giving the Friars another chance. West Virginia's done a good job in the second half, too, to get to the three-point shooters.
Xavier has been quiet, trying to get around, and is fouled that time by Thurlman. His third personal. You know, the Friars are so tough at home, too. They're 8-1 at home, 24-4 in their last 28 home games. Last year, they were 16-3 here at the Dunkin' Donuts Center. 8-1 this year here at home, and right now, trying to get back into this one.
Boy, Jeff Xavier's really been blanketed here tonight. Nothing. That's his first, isn't it?
Yeah, first point of the night. Jeff Xavier, point away for 1,000 in his career. Of course, a transfer coming here to the Friars.
And 700 plus at Manhattan.
And there it is. His 1,000th point. And his first 2 points of the night.
Alex Kellogg is in the Friar lineup.
38th player in school history. You know you've got some history when you've got 37 guys that have scored 1,000. Of course, three quarters of those coming at Manhattan College. There's man-to-man now. It's really gut check time for Providence. And West Virginia tough to come back on because their guard play is very solid and they tend to take very good care of the ball.
Norman moves in, kind of muscled in, loose ball. And Missoula down to get it now onto the floor, looking for a timeout, gets it. They're able to get it in control of the ball there. As West Virginia takes the timeout on top by 10.
Wait, Cam Thurlman got an earful there, but Thurlman came in averaging 3.9 minutes a game. He's played a lot in this one. Bob Huggins saying, hey guys, you're on the road, you're up by 10, work the clock, take good shots, and don't get sloppy out there. And if you do, I'll let you know about it.
Well, let's take a look now at our big stop of the game, brought to you by Cooper Tires. Don't give up a thing.
Now, West Virginia's defense has been good in this one. Really solid. Not so much dramatic, but just solid. Nice rejection there. And it's just the kind of hard work they've had inside in this ball game as that ball was rejected in there by Wellington Smith. They played good team defense, tough man-to-man. Made it difficult for Providence to get a lot of open looks from three-point land. And when Providence has not gone inside as effectively as they would like here tonight.
Well, West Virginia got 1-for-22 from three-point land against Cincinnati. Tonight they're 7-for-12, connecting much better all the way around, in fact. And the loose ball goes out of bounds and will remain on the West Virginia side of things. They are 50% from the floor tonight, so a dramatic change for them. After a dreadful game against Cincinnati. 2 seconds on the shot clock. Quick shot for Alexander from three-point land. Won't go. And they said that the shot clock had expired. Well, Huggins giving it to Joe Alexander. Don't even know how much time's on the clock.
A lot of just, you've got to mentally be sharp the whole game. Jeff McDermott, another good job by West Virginia to keep McDermott quiet. A lot of standing around by Providence right now when they need to execute and run their offense.
Alex Kellogg in the game for the first time tonight. This is Clark Kellogg's son, Alex Kellogg, the freshman from Columbus, Ohio.
Good defense by West Virginia. Providence really out of their rhythm. They need something, and Tim Welsh, timeout with 6 seconds.
Good boy. The way that thing was going.
Just good, solid defense, man-to-man. Everyone positioned between their man and the basket, solid, not allowing penetration. You can see Providence, a lot of standing, not a lot of cutting. No one really taking charge and looking to penetrate from that point guard slot. Dwayne Williams got to go up there and get the ball, get McDermott involved. He's got to take it to the goal. The clock, Providence's biggest issue right now, down by 10. Got a bonus situation. The next foul by West Virginia, Providence would be shooting two. So you get it to the goal, you might pick up the foul, stop the clock, and then you've got to convert.
Well, the Friars, who enjoyed a 13-point lead in the first half at 1 point, but all West Virginia since then. Friars were trailing by 3 at halftime, now find themselves down by 10. McDermott will cut inbound here. 6 seconds on the shot clock for the Friars. McDermott cuts in with 1 second on the clock and time expired.
Took it hard to the goal. Joe Alexander, solid defensive contact, but not enough to warrant the foul. Full court pressure by Providence. And right now for West Virginia, still a lot of time on the clock, but they want to work it, be good with the ball, and take time off that clock each possession.
Get it out of trouble, find its way down to Thurlman, who kicks it back out again.
Not a bad decision. He wasn't open when he caught it, looked open, worked the clock. It's a smart move. Way too early for Providence to just get into a foul mode, but they need a stop, and they need it now. Nice patience by West Virginia.
Six to shoot as Alexander cuts in on McKenzie. This is the mark on the far side. Butler regains it, and first shot clock now is Alexander back with it off the glass for two.
That is a big basket. Second chance, big rebound. West Virginia doing the job right now.
17 for Joe Alexander.
Oh! Circus shot right there.
Joe Alexander and the West Virginia Mountaineers on top by 10. Tigers are down by 10 points with 3:44 left to go. And a look at the foul situation as Thurlman just picked up his fourth personal. Alex Ruoff, who's been sitting a lot, and Butler, who has been sitting also with four. McKenzie is 69% foul shooter and gets the roll.
That was a big three-point play by McKenzie. See if Providence can get a stop here on defense. West Virginia just execute, work the ball. They got to get it over midcourt in the 10 seconds. Nice job.
Handled the Providence pressure fairly well.
Now, Darris Nick was so good with the ball, and Missoula's played well also. Now, West Virginia's very good. They run this motion offense against the man-to-man.
Alexander around McDermott is fouled. Well, couldn't get the roll to go. McDermott picks up his third personal.
Now, we've wondered at the beginning if Alexander, how he'd move with the groin injury. He looked great in the first half, not as offensive-minded in the second half. You wonder maybe if it stiffened a little bit at halftime, but he's really looked very, very strong for the Mountaineers tonight, which, you know, he's a key player, very effective.
One thing that he's done incredibly well is shoot free throws this year. He was just a 63.5% free throw shooter coming in. He worked on it a great deal and has got it up over 80% now, 83% on the season from the line. And he hits the first one.
And he gets to the line, you know, he's crafty. He had a nice rhythm there from the line. He took his time. A lot of guys rush from the stripe for whatever reason. It's Tim Welsh pinched to substitute and look for answers in this one, but West Virginia's been very solid with the ball again.
Kajuku and Hanke are in. 19 now for Alexander, so he gets both free throws. McKenzie, another circus shot, that time missed the mark.
Not a good look at all. When you need a basket, you got to get a high quality look. West Virginia's going to work clock now, spread the offense, run the motion. The Providence got to be careful not to overcommit, or they'll be giving up a layup on a backdoor cut.
There's Nichols cutting the lane, and the foul counted.
That's well done. That's the backdoor cut. From the top, Nichols with the finish. And if there was an MVP ball to be given out for West Virginia, it would be Nichols. Look at the catch. Check out the finish. And the little guy getting in there saying, hey, I can finish this thing off. I can go in the paint. He's been outside, and that is what you call a dagger-type basket. Up 13, West Virginia. And they're very tough from in front because they work it so well.
Nichols with 20 points. Can't get the free throw to go and complete the three-point play. Well, 20 points on the night for Nichols. Now Hanke gets free and fouled, and the bucket. Friars needed that. The time running out. Every time they've gone to Hanke, it seems that that has worked down low, but not getting to him enough.
He's got to be more integral to the offense. Get him the basketball, then the outside shots will open up that much more. I think what hurt Providence here tonight, they went to that three early, had some success, and then they started going to it too quickly, missed, and that's when West Virginia got themselves back into the ballgame.
15 points for Hanke, 6 for 7 from the field, continuing that outstanding field goal percentage.
But seven looks, you know, you got to get more looks for him. McDermott also hasn't been very offensive minded. Got to get him the ball more as well.
Kellogg coming in, Henke coming out. Continue to press.
Real difference though for West Virginia, I think, is the defense. They turned it on and played solidly.
Xavier thought he had a clean pick, but instead, that's the foul. A little quiet night for Xavier. Just 2 points, both coming from the foul line.
Foul is charged to Providence number one, Jeff Xavier.
Xavier second leading the team in scoring, foul, averaging over 12 a game. He's had two 27-point performances. We're at the Dunkin' Donuts Center in Providence, Rhode Island, with the West Virginia Mountaineers and the Providence College Friars. Don Orsillo, along with Ron Perry and Shauna Hassett. Friars in their home gray, the Mountaineers in blue. Alex Ruoff is 85% foul shooter at the line as checking back in is Wellington Smith. Nice game for Cam Throman, who does not get a lot of time, but had a lot of time tonight against the Friars.
Very solid effort. These guys get into some foul trouble. Bob Huggins went to Cam Thurman. I thought the play early when they needed the defensive intensity, when they look at films, that one where he dove for the ball. But things started to turn around there out of that timeout, and Thurman really gave it up. I'm not so sure that didn't help him get some more minutes.
Missoula checking back in, Ruoff coming out. 2.5 minutes left to go on this one. Friars down by 12. Cutting in off the back end, Henke trying to grab it, but the rebound that time for Missoula came down.
Missoula really is an aggressive kid. He's made some good plays out there defensively. Offensively, came off the bench in the first half. He did a good job as well. This is where West Virginia is very tough. They spread offense, they work the clock, and Nichols, he commandeers that offense.
Let's check in with Shauna Hassett. Shauna.
Hey guys, I'm here with Joe Mazzulla's father. You must be very proud of your son.
Things are working out very well for us, absolutely.
He's having a great game. I actually heard from one of his friends that said that his cell phone answering machine said, "I'm in Providence, beating Providence, can't make the phone."
I don't believe that. I think Joe's a little bit more humble than that.
Yeah.
I hope he is. I mean, he's playing well, the team's playing very well. It's a big win. It's a big win for us.
I'm sure your presence is helping out.
Well, I just encourage him to continue to work hard and keep his head on straight. And, you never know what can happen. You're going to be ready when it's your turn. And he plays hard. He's playing great defense. I mean, I think he's been responsible for quite a few runs, and I think he's picked up the tempo very well. I'm very proud of him.
Congratulations. Back to you, Don.
All right, Shauna, thank you very much. Going to be very special to see his son play right here at the Dunkin' Donuts Center.
He's got, you know, there's a lot of pride there, right? And you see his son out there in the court. He's got to be feeling very, very good about the way he's played tonight, because he's been really a key member of this effort for West Virginia. There's the defense again. West Virginia, a very impressive game. This is a tough place to go on the road and win, and they've done it convincingly on the heels of a game where they shot the ball so poorly, Don. So this was a big game for West Virginia. And just Providence's second loss here of the season.
Johnny West, West Virginia. 69-39 loss last time out to Cincinnati.
Johnny West in the game, Jerry West's son. Jerry, of course, on the 1959 West Virginia team that took a loss to California in the NCAA finals.
Taken down here on the Friars. Trailed by 14. John Butler got tripped up, went down to the floor, and a turnover here as McDermott gets it back. No foul called. Long range for McKenzie, looking for three, trying to get three of them back and can't do it as that time West went up to get the rebound.
Well, it's West Virginia. You've got to give them credit. They came back in the first half and really continued to play very solid basketball in the second half. Darris Nichols and Joe Alexander leading the way, but it was a strong defensive effort again by the Mountaineers.
The Friars, who have been 8-1 at home in their last 9 home games, and of course 24-4 in their last 28. West Virginia coming in here and able to grab the victory against the Friars.
Nice execution again there. Very, very difficult to play West Virginia when they've got the lead like this, and they work in the ball around as Jeff Xavier gets his first field goal of the game.
Wow. Very quiet night for Xavier, leading scorer for the Friars. Two free throws and that three-pointer, so five on the night. Don't miss more great Big East Hoops action from ESPN Plus Saturday as the Providence College Friars, led by one of the league's best all around, Jeff McDermott, head to the Big Apple to square off against St. John's. Red Storm, led by Anthony Mason Jr. and Justin Burrell. That's Providence versus St. John's, Saturday at noon, Eastern from ESPN Plus. Nichols misses the first one. West Virginia, upcoming games. For Mountaineers, Pittsburgh at Pittsburgh, and they're back home against Rutgers. A couple of big wins for Rutgers. We saw Rutgers earlier this year against the Friars.
Yeah, they've got a few. Three of their next five are at home. At Pitt will be a very difficult game. What a rivalry, West Virginia and Pitt. And of course, Pitt losing today at home to Connecticut.
Well, Connecticut's played very good basketball since the Friars beat them earlier this year as Hankey with a turnaround.
Hankey's been effective. He really has been the offensive answer here tonight for the Friars.
18 for Hankey.
Now the perimeter defense by West Virginia was good here tonight. They took the Friars' three-point shooting and made it ineffective, and an impressive double-digit victory here in Providence's home court in a very disciplined way.
Bob Huggins, over 600 wins, and he grabs a win tonight in his first ever battle against Tim Welsh and the Friars. Harris Nichols and Joe Alexander combining to get it done tonight for West Virginia.
Well, good job by West Virginia. On the road, really took the crowd out, executed, took good care of the ball, and got it done when they needed to.
Once again, our final 65. 77 as PC drops one tonight to West Virginia. For Ron Perry, Shauna Hassett, and our entire ESPN Plus crew, I'm Don Orsillo. Tune in Saturday, February 9th. Friars travel to St. John's. Coverage begins at noon. For more information, check out ESPN Plus or log on to ESPN-Plus.com.